An AI can never possess consciousness, no matter how complex it becomes. I want to state this upfront, and if you stick around, I will show you how to use Burkhard Heim's model to prove that this will never change. Hello and welcome to Six Dimensions in Color. My name is Hannes Schmid, and on this channel I present to you the worldview of Burkhard Heim in understandable language and with clear examples. Ever since computers have existed, people have asked themselves, can a computer be conscious or attain consciousness somehow? The capabilities of large language models like our beloved ChatGPT have become quite impressive indeed. And some people even claim these models show signs of intelligent behavior, of conscious behavior, and must be treated accordingly even. But all these claims are based on certain basic assumptions on the world which are questionable. I'm going to talk about these assumptions in this video. But before we start, no matter if AIs will ever possess consciousness or not, of the utmost importance is that you develop your own consciousness, your own emotional intelligence and resilience. NATHAL training is the best you can do on this behalf. NATHAL has proven since 1980 that it can produce unprecedented qualities and states of mind and emotions in a shockingly short time. Go to my website nathaltraining.ae and subscribe to my Instagram channel to learn more. To start with, I want to make an important distinction. Have you noticed when we are talking about AI, we are indeed talking about artificial intelligence? No one has ever talked about AC, like an artificial consciousness. We have to start to distinguish between colloquial language, presensationalism, and what is really there. It is often implied that consciousness is a consequence of intelligence, and that intelligence is only a matter of sufficiently complex computational operations. However, this is a completely unfounded assumption. There is no evidence to support this claim. And what is more, it is also claimed often that it makes no difference whether these computational operations are being performed in a biological brain or in a standard silicon computer chip. Naturally, this view on consciousness is based on a purely materialistic view of the world. This view has been shaped by transhumanists like Ray Kurzweil, head of Google Technology. If one is convinced that the world is matter and nothing but matter, then one has no choice but to make such claims, because consciousness could not arise from anything else. This is being stated axiomatically then. But in truth, no neuroscientist, no psychologist, no philosopher has ever come up with even a satisfying definition of consciousness, let alone an explanation of how it should arise. It indeed seems to escape intellectual analysis entirely. Now let me briefly summarize what I've been telling on this channel over the past years. First, according to Burkhard Heim, there are two transcendent dimensions of the world, dimensions X5 and X6, in which non-material processes occur and reside. Second, consciousness, as Burkhard Heim understood it, is a consequence of structural transformations in this trans realm. Third, the transcendent life process is coupled to the living matter through a standing light wave in the DNA, so-called biophotons. Four, there are countless credible reports of paranormal phenomena, amongst others spiritual healing, teleportation, telekinesis, ghostly encounters, and many more. And five, there is an existence after death. If you take only one of these points seriously, or take seriously only one account of a paranormal phenomenon, you have for yourself already disproved the materialist worldview. But now I want to substantiate my initial statement that an AI can never attain consciousness by using Burkhard Heim's model in more detail. But first, for all new viewers on this channel, I hope this video makes you curious enough to dive deeper into the worldview and theory of Burkhard Heim. If you'll enjoy this video, like and subscribe and leave me comments. Now let's see what happens inside a computer from the perspective of Burkhard Heim's model. In earlier videos, I discussed the structure of the physical world, the intellectual layering of the entities we encounter, the elementary particles, atoms, molecules, and the macro collectives of everyday life. These different levels of complexity we order along the axis X5 in the terms of so-called totalities, which help us distinguish these different levels of organization. The objects of everyday life, Heim called the macro collectives, they are assigned to totality number 6. Above this begins the realm of the living matter, which is, beside being far more complex than inanimate matter, also connected to even higher structural realms, which are no more material. All psychic processes, including perception, reaction, and memory, they occur in these non-material realms through structural transformations. Heim called these activity streams. And through these activity streams, matter is organized in these improbable ways that we observe in living organism and in our very own body. The key support for this part of Heim theory, the activity coupling from the transcendent realm to matter, is the existence of biophotons, which Heim even predicted before they were discovered by Professor Fritz Albert Popp in 1972. To summarize these findings, activity streams from higher intellectual levels affect a photon field that's being contained inside the DNA. And these photon fields then affect genetic transcription. However, this process cannot arise with electronic state, that is, with electrons, as we have them in computers. This is due to the deeper structure of elementary particles, which Heim discovered. His structural theory says that the fermions, that is, the electrons, protons, neutrons, etc., they possess so-called shielding fields, and they make it almost impossible to have a stable coupling with any transcendent activity stream. They are simply too inert. And therefore, a computer cannot live in any meaningful sense of the word. It cannot interact with transcendent entities. They cannot couple in a stable way to a silicon chip and what is happening on it. To be sure, this holds true, of course, for computers as we build them today. And it also still holds true if we go for quantum computing, because quantum computers eventually are also based on electronic states. The only concession to make here is that it is indeed quite possible to alter probabilistic states in matter through, for example, mental concentration, that is, by a truly paranormal process. By the way, I'd be very interested how easy it will be to, like, hack a quantum computer by pure thought, by concentrating on it. Again, to be sure on this point, the fact that it is indeed possible to alter microstates, even of electrons, through mental concentration, does not constitute that these can possess a living consciousness or anything comparable. The connection must be stable, and it must be even self-stabilizing. This is something that only the living DNA can achieve of all the natural phenomena we have discovered. Even devices for so-called instrumental transcommunication, that is, a radio to contact the dead, like Heim experimented himself with, they cannot provide this. They are inherently unstable and unpredictable. A computer is, from the human perspective, a functional artifact. And such artifacts, Heim assigned to a pseudo-totality 7 in his intellectual layering. This has nothing to do with the biological structural level 7. So no matter how big or how computationally powerful a computer becomes, and regardless of all the intelligence, the apparent intelligence it simulates, it will never possess more intelligence and more consciousness than a wrench. This pocket calculator enables me to calculate way faster and far more precise than I could do in my head. And I'm sure OpenAI's data centers can beat any chess master, any human chess master alive. But it does not change the fact that this is only an upscaling of this device in my hands. I would never presume that this would be anything out of the ordinary. Everything we have built so far are mere extensions of human capabilities. They are and remain tools. By Heim's model, every tiniest virus particle has more intelligence than the biggest computer. People like Ray Kurzweil dream of uploading their consciousness into a computer and by this way becoming immortal in a way. And maybe this will even be possible one day, that you copy your brain activity into a computer, what is allegedly the cause of your consciousness. But there is no reason to believe that either before or after the person's death, this copied model will somehow awake to a living consciousness inside the computer. And from the transcendent perspective, there is no means of making contact because the hardware is wrong. The only thing that remains on Earth is a kind of electronic zombie. There is still much more to say about the subject of AI and consciousness, and I will make at least two more videos about that, for which I would very much like your input, so drop me a few lines in the comment section. If you feel up to the task to contribute to the exploration and continuation of Heim theory, I want to invite you to join our community on Discord. Click on the link in the video description to join. The main message for this video is, no one needs to fear the utopias and dystopias of the trans and posthumanists. No matter how powerful computers become, conscious existence only happens in six dimensions and in color.